Hello, good beans, and welcome back to Midnight Requiem. Today we'll be talking about Chalino Sanchez. Real name Rosalino Sanchez Felix was born on Las Flechas, a small ranch in Sinaloa. He was the youngest of seven children. His parents were Santos Sanchez and Senorina Felix. Chalino Sanchez, pomitiously called El Rey de Corrido, he is considered one of the most influential narcorrido singers of the late 20th century, a pioneer in Mexican music. Chalino grew up poor and lived in difficult life. His birth name was Rosalino, but he preferred his nickname Chalino, since he considered Rosalino sounded too feminine. In 1975, his sister was raped, and 2 years later, in 1977, Chalino saw the man at a party and allegedly shot him in revenge, killing him. After committing this act, Sanchez left for Tijuana with his gun and a Jesus Marverde chain during his time in Tijuana. He worked as a coyote, an immigrant smuggler, taking immigrants into the United States. The same year, Chalino himself crossed into the United States as an undocumented immigrant worker. He began in Oregon and later moved to Los Angeles to live with his aunt in Inglewood, California. He washed dishes, sold cars, and according to his friends, dealt with small quantities of marijuana and cocaine. He also helped his brother Armando run an immigrant smuggling operation. Chalino met Marcelia Vallejos in 1984. They married while she was pregnant with their son, Aiden Sanchez, and later had a second child. They were married until Chalino Sanchez's death in 1992. In 1984, Armando was shot and killed in a hotel in Tijuana, which inspired Chalino to compose his first corrido, or ballet. Around this time, Chalino was arrested. He began composing songs for his fellow inmates and anyone with a story worth telling. Chalino began to earn money through his compositions and would be gifted with guns and presents by his customers. Among his many customers were Lucio Villarreal, El Pelapacas, and Jorge El Cuquillo Castro. A small group known as Los Cuatro de la Frontera recommended Chalino go to a recording studio in the Olympic Boulevard in Los Angeles. The studio was called San Angel Records and was owned by Angel Mascal. Originally, another artist was meant to sing Chalino's song, but he canceled, so Chalino sang his own songs. In 1989, Chalino recorded his first cassette of 15 songs. He sold cassettes from his car at local swap meets, bakeries, and other business across South Central Los Angeles. Chalino connected with another Mexican immigrant, Pedro Rivera, who had set up a small recording studio in Long Beach, California, called Cintas Acuaria. This studio allowed aspiring musicians to record cheaply. Chalino and Rivera pioneered the prohibited corridos, corrido prohibido, songs that mythologize drug smugglers, murderers, and violentes. The Cintas Acuaria roster, which later included Pedro's children Lupillo, Juan, and the late Jenny Rivera, was not initially aired on radio, but they became the foundation of the Latino genre in Los Angeles. Promoters across the Southland quickly sought to book Chalino at their clubs. Chalino sang his songs in his cadence and Sinaloan slang, something no big singer had previously done. On 25th January 1992, Chalino was performing at the Plaza Los Arcos restaurant and nightclub in the desert city of Coachella, 120 miles east of Los Angeles. Reportedly, Chalino was set to perform at 10 p.m. on the main stage. At around 7 p.m., the center was at maximum capacity with around 400 people in attendance. During his performance, Chalino began taking songs requests from the audience. Shortly before midnight, Eduardo Gallegos, 32, a local unemployed mechanic from Thermal, California, under the influence of heroin and alcohol, requested El Gallo de Sinaloa. Immediately afterwards, Gallegos jumped up on stage and pointed a .25 caliber pistol at Chalino. In retaliation, Chalino pulled his 10mm pistol from his waistband and then began a gun battle. Dalejo's first four shots hit Chalino twice in the chest near his armpit, striking his lung, and one bullet hit accordionist Ignacio Nacho Hernandez in the thigh. Chalino's shots missed Gallegos and accidentally hit 20-year-old Claudio René Carranza in the right leg, hitting the main artery, who was later pronounced dead at John F. Kennedy Memorial Hospital. Chalino and Gallegos opened fire at each other while ensuing in a brief chase into the crowd below. 9 to 15 shots were fired, and around 7 more people were reportedly hit in the exchange as well. Gallegos was wrestled to the floor by a bystander until Gallegos was eventually shot in the face with his own pistol. Gallegos and Chalino were both listed as critical and both transported to Desert Regional Hospital in Palm Springs. Chalino Sanchez was in the hospital for 11 days and was released home without any charges. Eduardo Gallegos, who survived his wounds, was convicted of attempted murder and was sentenced to 20 years to life in prison. The shooting was reported by ABC World News Tonight, and in both English and Spanish language newspapers, Chalino saw success with his sales and began gaining airplay. Although it was a single old-fashioned non-narco song called Nieves de Enero, for his next Los Angeles appearance at El Parque, doors had to close at 6 p.m. 5 to 6 hours before he was due on stage. On 15 May 1992, 4 months after the Coachella incident and during a performance at the Salon Bogambilias in Culiacán, Chalino was handed a note from someone in the crowd. The note is commonly believed to have been a death threat whereby he would be killed after the song, but this has never been confirmed. A video recording of the song Alma Enamorada shows Chalino crumpling up the note before singing the song as if nothing happened. After midnight, Chalino drove away from the club with two of his brothers, a cousin, and several young women. They were pulled over by a group of armed men in black Chevrolet Suburbans and told Chalino their commander wanted to see him. Chalino agreed and got into one of their cars while the others stayed behind. The following day, at 6 in the morning, two farmers found Chalino's body at an irrigation canal near Highway 15 near the neighborhood of Los Laureles, Caloocan. He was blindfolded and his wrists were red and had rope marks. He had been shot in the back of the head twice. Since his death, Chalino's fame and recordings have grown in popularity. Chalino still amasses millions of music streams 3 decades after his death, plus over 200 million views for his music video of Alma Enamorada on YouTube alone, and continues to be a fixture on many Spanish language radio stations. He remains a popular artist with young Hispanic listeners, as well as earning the praise artists outside his target audience, including rapper Snoop Dogg. An 8-part podcast, Ídolo, the ballet of Chalino Sanchez, was made about Chalino's life. It also investigates the circumstances of his murder. Leave a white heart in the comments in remembrance of them. And as always, be loving and caring, my good beings.